सो लास्ट टाइम जो था वी वर स्टक विद दिस ऑल्टरनेट होल्ड लोडिंग रिस्ट्रिक्शन. ऑल्टरनेट होल्ड लोडिंग जो रिस्ट्रिक्शन है दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड एज पर द सोलास चैप्टर 12. सो वेयर इट इज रिटन इन द सोलास चैप्टर 12 हियर रेगुलेशन नंबर 14 रिस्ट्रिक्शन फॉर द सेलिंग विद एन होल्ड एम्प्टी. दिस अबाउट दिस ऑल्सो आई मेड अ वीडियो बट एनी हाउ आई विल मेक यू आई जस्ट टेल अम विद इन फ्यू. So it states it is having two points, that bulk carrier of 150 meter in length and upwards of single side skin construction carry cargo having a density and above if not meeting the requirement for withstanding flooding of any one cargo hold as in specified in regulation 5.1. Okay, so if a single hull bulk carrier, if it does not comply with the flooding requirement, that means it cannot withstand, if it cannot withstand any one cargo hold which is flooded, so it cannot it should not do the alternate hold loadings. Okay, then provided that such amended as adopted in forced has taken in accordance with the provision of the article 7 article 8. Okay, shall not sail with any hold loaded to less than 10% of the hold's maximum allowable cargo. So the important parts are this one, which I am marking in yellow. This one. So if not meeting the requirement for withstanding flooding requirement, if it is not meeting, then it should not carry alternate hold loading. And bulk carriers 150 meter of length, it is saying, and upwards also it's saying, of a single side skin, matlab single hull, that is single hull. Okay, having a density this one and above, if not meeting this requirement, so it should not go with alternate hold loading. As well as here, shall not sail with hold loaded to less than 10% of the maximum allowable cargo weight when it is fully loaded condition after reaching 10 years. This means if it is not meeting this requirement for withstanding the flooding, then it should not sail without, if it is not meeting this, then it should not go, it should not go to sea without loading less than 10%. Means at least 10% of the hold, means all holds, at least 10% of all holds to be loaded, or more than 10% to be loaded when it is reaching a age of 10 years. Then what? The applicable full load condition for this regulation is load equal or greater than 90% of a ship's deadweight as relevant at the assigning freeboard. So if here is the 10% for 10 years of ages, as well it is applicable that 90% only you can load, that is, that should be what you will load, that is 10%, and all this means 10% you will load or more you will load, that total amount of cargo shall not go beyond 90% of ship's dead weight. Because you cannot load, first thing, this is flooded, so you are not following the criteria of flooding, so you will not go for alternate hold loading. So what you should do, you should hold each hold, you should load each hold with more than 10% or 10% of cargo. So that should also be not more than 90% of the ship's dead weight. So this is what it is saying. So we will move back to MSBC. Okay, this is finished up. This is all about that the cargo shall be trimmed reasonable level. So it should be trimmed with a reasonable level. So this means the over trimming should not be there. This means that, and further we have town, so down we will have more one. So here non-cohesive, okay, appendix one is the provisions given. Yes, here Here also we can see that for the non-coercive bulk cargoes having an angle of repose less than or equal to 30 degrees, then shall be carrying it according to the provision applicable to the stowage of the grain cargoes. So grain cargoes means this is grain stability, grain code. They require the grain code. So in that also the cancelling and the securing arrangement of the division and the bin bulkheads and the stability effect of the free cargo surfaces should be there. Okay, now non-cohesive having angle of repose greater than 30 to 35, so 30 to 35, this is. So here what is the trimming procedure? The cargo shall be trimmed according to the following criteria. What is the criteria? The criteria is delta S shall not be more than 1.5 or shall not exceed b by 10. So b by 10 is for those vessels which are less than or equal to 15 meters, and if it is more, then it will go by 1.5. If it is beam is more than 15 meters, then it should not go by more than 1.5 meters. So what is here 1.5 meters? 1.5 meters, the top crown, the crown is there. So the top of the crown and the bottom of the crown shall not have a vertical distance, vertical height distance of more than 1.5 meters. So this is, and it should be approved by the competent authority and all this. Then non-cohesive bulk cargoes having an angle of repose greater than 35 degrees. Then what is there? There is B by 10 and 2 meters. Same things what was before, like B10 and 1.5. The same things are there. Nothing difference. Okay. Now this is methods to define angle of repose. This is given in appendix 2. And there are many three methods which has been given over there. So we will go through that. Cargo which may liquefy is group A. Nothing more than, yes, special construction of the filled cargo ship. So the cargoes which are having moisture content excess of the TML, transportable moisture limit. If we have a cargo which is having more than transportable moisture limit water content, then we should carry them in a specially constructed cargo ships. So that can be also carried, but it should be in a specially constructed cargo ships. So this is what is their designs and all this. 7.3 is having all of these divisions and all requirements, but this we should know that what is this is nothing but approved by the administration and all this, but here we should know that we can load these type of cargoes also which is having moisture limit more than TML also. The provisions, high density and all divisions and all the woods. Okay. Testing procedure for cargo which may liquefy. Yeah, appendix 2 again. Okay, so this is spot check. This is complementary test procedure for determining the possibility of liquefaction. This is also known as Kane test. So half filled cylinder, cane or a similar container 0.5 or 1 liter capacity with a sample of the material, take the cane in one hand and bring it down sharply to strike to a hard surface such as solid table from a height of about 0.2 meter, that is 20 centimeters. Repeat the procedures 25 times at 1 or 2 second interval. Okay, so what is this? We have a cane which is 1 liter or 0.5 liter. Generally we have beer cane. We can take the beer cane also which is 1 liter or half a liter. We have to fill the cargo inside and then we have to bang it 25 times. Here 25 times we have to bang from a height of 20 centimeters or 0.2 meters. So how I was remembering this 25 and this 20 centimeter was like that we have to bang it 25 times, means we have to beat it 25 times. So beating is 25. So if you want to beat something, so it is more you beat because you are more angry. So 25 times I was remembering like that. Possesses a chemical hazard. So this is group B. Nothing special over here. This one is that. Then what is material hazardous only in bulk is MHB. So this possesses chemical hazards. Okay. To avoid contamination of all foodstuffs shall be stored. So separated from a material which is indicated as toxic, separated by complete compartment or hold all infectious, separated from radioactive material, away from corrosive material. So these are there. So just for the reference that, because foodstuff, what about the foodstuff? Can we load or cannot we load? So this is the answer. Can we load foodstuff or we cannot load? So this is the answer over here. And the provisions is also given. Okay, now the danger good list of IMDG shall be consulted by additional requirement with regard to the storage and segregation of the package dangerous good. Okay, so this one is okay. This is the full list. This is the full list. This list is having 1, 2, 3 classes are written over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Then here, and they are marked over here. So what is there is the same list is contained in IMDG also in chapter 7 of volume 1. So from there also you can check it out, the same thing. It means that the danger is good in the packed form. It is not that it can be only loaded on container ships. It can be loaded on the bulk carriers. It can be loaded on the ro-ros and barges. That the provision of that is given in. This means that on the container ship, if you want to load a dangerous good in a packed form, you have to load according to IMDG volume 1 chapter 7.4. in which I have told these in the my IMDG videos also. So if you want to go in more detail over there, you can check 7.4, 7.5, 7.6, 7.7. So all these provisions also I have explained over there also. There is more proper explanations. So these groups, this means because it is MSBC, so it is for bulk carrier. So it will go according to the IMDG volume 1 chapter 7.5, what I remember is 7.5. So from there only this list is coming, and then it is having like this, away from, separated from, then separated by complete compartment, separated longitudinally by intervening compartment, then excess segregation if any is shown in the DG list if it is X or individual schedule of the code. Okay, so if cross is marked or X-ray is there, this means it can be only loaded as per the DG list or whatever will be mentioned over there, otherwise it cannot be loaded. Like class 9 cannot be loaded with anything. You have to see the DG list, or at MHB also you have to check the you have to check the code, this code here you have to check what is the requirement and the provision, and here is the 3. So okay, 3 is separated by complete compartment or a hold from the means, either by the vertical or horizontal separations and all this. Generally these diagrams are always being drawn away from, separated from, separated by complete compartment or this. There are many books in which these diagrams are being drawn. So these diagrams is only for bulk area, not for all. For different, if you want to see IMDG code is the best, that where you can see the separate, that how the diagrams differ. Because here you see this is the bulk cargo has been there. Then again there are more. This is unless otherwise required in the section or the individual schedule for the cargoes of group B. Then how the cargoes of group V will go, segregation about these things. So this is the table for the segregation of group B cargo. So flammable, solid and la la la, and how it can be go with 4.1, 4.2, 4.3, 5.1, 5.6, 6.1, 7, 8, 9. You can see here 6 decimal 2 is not there, 5 decimal 2 is not there. So it cannot be loaded with that things. And class 1 is not there, class 2 is not there, class 3 is not there. So it cannot be with that one. Then again, it don't have like away from. So you cannot see anywhere 1 written here. Generally 2, 3 and crosses been marked. So the meaning of 2, 3 and crosses over here. That separated by a complete compartment or hold from, and segregation if any should be as per the schedule in this code. Okay, then transportation of solid waste in bulk. So for the waste should be firstly written over there, that waste, and then the name of that particular cargo should be there. So nothing's okay, this one, documentations. So in addition to the required documentation for the transportation of solid bulk cargo, all the transbound movement of the waste shall be complied by the waste movement documents. So we required for the waste movement documents from the point at which a transbound movement commences to the point of the disposal. This document shall be available at all times to the competent authority and all the persons involving in the management of the waste. Then classification of the waste. This is a waste containing only one constituent, which is the cargo, subject to the provision of this code applicable to the codes of class. So classes are 4.1 to 9. Okay, storage and handling of the waste. So waste shall be stored and handled in accordance with the provision of the section 1 to 9. 1 to 9 means the sections which is given in MSBC code. So 1 to 9 sections over here, not from anywhere else. So 1 to 9 is given over. So we have to load according to this of this code, and with an additional provision included in the individual schedule of cargoes in group B. We have just gone through the segregation of this group B, the table. Yeah, this one, this table, segregation between the solid bulk cargo possesses chemical hazard, that is here group B. So we have to do according to this. Okay, then chapter section 11, they are informative. So here is not much is given informations, storage factor, conversion table, how to convert. Okay, reference to related information and recommendations. So reference list, classification of the stability information. Here are these things which are nice, like SOLAS chapter 2 part 1, 5.1 stability information, 6.8.1 stability information, 6.9.2.1 stability, 6.9.4 loading and trim of the bulk, loading and trimming of the bulk cargoes, SOLAS chapter 12 regulation stability information. So these all are given. So this is good that it has been written only at one place, so that anyone can refer accordingly. This is then fire extinguishing arrangement shall be for A, B, C. It should be as per these things. So it is also mentioned ventilation, also mentioned how to ventilate, go where, personal protection, everything is written. Just the need is to open the book where we need self-contained breathing apparatus. Gas detecting equipment for the fumigation. Okay, minimum informative documents, which all documents we need. So these all documents. So chapter 13 is also, it is having everything. insulation of the machinery space boundaries, so how it should be, everything. Yeah. Fumigation, segregation. Entry in enclosed spaces, this is important. Okay, now appendix 1 is individual schedule of the solid bulk cargoes. So there are many cargoes, but not to go through all, I will select few of them. I have few of them which are generally being asked. So here we have, so first one is coal. So for coal, it is given in page 122. So all the things about the coal. See also the appendix to this schedule also, we have to see. So characteristics, this is coal is bituminous and anthracite, is a natural solid combustible material, consists of the amorphous carbon and hydrocarbons, angle of repose, not available, density is in stowage factor, size MHB group A and B, hazardous coal may create flammable atmosphere. What are the hazards related to the coal? Coal may create flammable atmosphere, may heat spontaneously, may deplete the oxygen concentration, may corrode the metal structure, can liquefy if the predominantly fine 75% less than 5 mm coal. So hazards of the coal is there. Refer the appendix. So we will see where we are going to refer the appendix. So for coal and everything, it is stowage and segregation. For the coal, we will see this one. Now this whole cleaning, clean and dry as relevant to the hazard of the cargo, weather precautions. So it is also been given over there. So what all precautions when a cargo may liquefy during the voyage, in case that the moisture content of the cargo in excess to the TML and the cargo is carried in a ship other than the special construction. If other than special construction, so when a cargo may liquefy during the voyage, in case the moisture content of the cargo is in excess to TML, so it may liquefy. Liquefy is liquefaction of the coal is also a hazard. If excess of the TML, the water is excess of the TML, then, and for that, other than special construction, ships should be there. So all fitted with the cargo ships complying with the requirements of subsection 7.3.2 of this code. So 7.3.2 of this code. So this is what I have told before also, that special construction of the filled cargo ships. So these are also there. like these, what all others are also there. So the moisture content of the cargo shall be kept less than the TML during the voyage unless express provided otherwise. So weather precautions, what we should do is, you can read these things. The moisture content of the cargo shall be kept less than its TML during the voyage unless express provided otherwise. In this individual schedule, the cargo shall not be handled during the precipitation unless expressed. All this, so you can just read for a moment or pause it and read. So these all, then what I want to show is, emergencies. So emergency action in event of fire, button down, exclusion of the air may be sufficient to control the fire. Do not use water. So don't use water. Seek expert advice and consider heading to the nearest port. So this is, if you will say, you can say it, we have said as per the MSBC, we are going to go for the nearest port. It has been written over there. Medical first aid, refer to the medical first MFAG guide. Remark, the use of CO2 or the inert gas, if available, should be withheld until fire is apparent. Okay, now appendix. What is the appendix? So they have told that before, please refer to the appendix. So this is what I mean. Coal may emit methane containing 5 to 16% of the methane, which are explosive. Methane is lighter than the air and may therefore accumulate in the upper region. Then they can deplete the oxygen. Spontaneous heating, reaction with the water, then segregation and stowage requirement. Resistant to the fire, class 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Not stored adjacent to the hot areas, separated longitudinally by intervening complete compartment or hold from goods of class 1 other than division 1.4. Then general requirement for all the types of the cargo. These things I have explained in MDG. The general requirement for all the types of these cargoes provided in written to the master, characteristic of cargo. Then here is including removal of the cargo, button all electric cables and the components situated in the cargo space and the adjacent spaces are free from the defects. So these all, okay, means to provide the measures, measuring the temperature of the cargo hold, means shall be there 0 to 100 degrees, which is written that there should be, that we can measure. Beyond 100, maybe it will not work. Monitoring of the methane, oxygen and carbon dioxides. Here, unless expressed, provided otherwise, surface ventilation shall be conducted in all cargo spaces carrying this cargo for the first 24 hours after departure from the loading port. So, unless expressed, provided otherwise. Unless it is expressed, it is told or written. Yep. Or provided otherwise, surface ventilation shall be conducted, means surface ventilation should be conducted after space carrying the cargo for first 24 hours after departure, that is after 24 hours of departure, you should carry out the surface ventilations unless it is being expressed that you should not carry out. If it is not written that you should not carry out, don't carry out. If it is not written, then you can carry out. When the methane concentration monitoring within 24 hours after departure are not at the acceptable low level, surface ventilation shall be maintained except for an appropriate period for the gas monitoring. Okay, and close working spaces such as storeroom, then carpenter shop, passageways, tunnels, etc. are regulatory monitor, means we have to keep on monitoring for the methane, oxygen, carbon monoxide levels in these areas also. Bilges shall be frequently pumped out, and coal emission and all this. Okay, this is the most important. This cargo shall only be accepted for the loading when the temperature of the cargo is not higher than 55 degrees Celsius. If higher, then reject it. Okay, somebody was asking this carbon monoxide ppm. So it is 50 ppm written over here. Here, that it should not be more than 50 ppm. Or exhibit to a steady rise. This is been asked. So please, this one, the carbon monoxide level in the cargo spaces reaches 50 ppm or exhibiting a steady rise over the 3 consecutive days, a self-heating condition may be developed. So that's why the carbon monoxide ppm is also important. If it is more reaching 50, so it can be okay. Equipments and all the settings, spaces, measuring, all these are appendices of the coal. Now the other cargoes are coal slurry. So we will again go to those cargo only. Yeah. DRIA. So DRIA is given here. This is 145 page. So fines and all this, angle of repose, bulk density, stowage factor to be verified by group B, it is MHP, approximate sizes, hazards. So hazard is material may slowly evolve hydrogen after contact with water. So we have to keep away this guy from the water. So this is the hazard. So material may slowly evolve, then temporary self-heating of about 30 degrees may be expected after the material handling in bulk. This cargo is non-combustible or has a low fire risk. Okay, when it is being stored with IMDG, then how it's to be stored? This thing. Then hold cleaning, the hold spaces shall be clean, dry and free from salt. Here it is written free from salt. For the coal, it is not written residue of the previous cargo also. So this is generally written for all of them, but this is something different here and there. Weather precautions, what to do. This cargo shall be kept as dry as applicable during the loading and the voyage. Open stowage is acceptable prior to the loading. So open storage shall be accepted prior to the loading. This cargo shall not be loaded during the precipitation, means no water during loading. Okay, then loading, the cargo shall not be loaded when the temperature is more than 65. For coal it was 55, for this guy it is 65, means DRIA. Where practicable, ballast tanks adjacent to the cargo spaces containing this cargo other than double bottom tanks shall be kept empty. So this also, surface ventilation only, either natural or mechanical. This also is there. When was with the ventilation, then I told what is natural, what is mechanical, or what is that. Then carriage for the quantitative measurement of the hydrogen, a suitable detector shall be on board while this cargo is carried. So measurement of the hydrogen should be there, and the detector should be there in the on board the ship when carrying DRI. Clean up, then emergency procedures are given here. Button down, do not use water in this case also. Seek expert advice. Firstly, we have to seek the expert advice. Early application of an inert gas to a smothering situation may be effective. Precaution should be made for the grab discharge if serious heating occurs. For medical, MFAG. So this emergency is more important than DRIB, not to be confused with an iron spoon spent, such as lumps, pellets and cold molded. So here it is also for DRIA. This is hot module. Mrs. Cold would do. So direct reduced iron is the metallic manufacturing process followed by the iron oxide and the temperature below the fusion point of the iron cold module brittle should be defined as those which have been molded at the temperature of under 650 or which have a density of less than 0.5 grams per centimeter cube. Then its characteristics, lump sizes, hazards, is DRI may react with the water and air, produces hydrogen and heat. The heat produced may causes the ignition. Oxygen in an enclosed spaces may be depleted. So these are then when dealing with the IMDG and this DRIB, then this should be followed. Hold cleanness means clean, dry, free from salt and residue of the previous cargoes. Wooden fixtures such as batten shall be removed. So in this one was not given in DRIA, but it is given in DRIB. Weather precautions, same, that should not be loaded, not to be loaded when precipitation. Okay, loading. So here also, adjacent ballast tank other than double bottom shall be kept empty. Weather deck closure shall be inspected and tested to ensure the integrity and should not be loaded when the temperature is excess of 65 degrees Celsius. Precautions are here. So for each cargo we can go one by one. Then emergency in. Okay, for this one is button down, do not use or seek expert as earlier. Inert gas smoothing situation effective if a fire situation develops. The ship should be taken in steam, not additional carbon monoxide. So these, see what is here, is inert gas. It is only given this things. The cargo space shall be maintained under an inert atmosphere containing less than 5% the hydrogen content of the atmosphere. In the cargo space shall be maintained less than 1% by the volume. So, but in the precaution it should be given. Like here, this early application of the inert gas to an smoothing situation may be effective if a fire situation develops. The ship should make for the nearest suitable port and neither water, steam nor additional carbon dioxide should be used at this stage. So if nitrogen gas is available, the use of this gas to be kept the oxygen concentration down will contain the fire. So in DRIB nitrogen can be used. For DRIA also we can see like this, everything is written here, just we need for this, nothing is written. So for DRIB is the nitrogen, it is written over here, this nitrogen. Okay, now the other cargo is there. Sometimes they say DRIC also, but I cannot find DRIC over here. But DRIC is not having more hazard, it is in group C. It is not possessing chemical nor liquefaction any hazards. They are small fines only. iron ore. So this is also Venus. So what is iron ore? Varies from the dark colors. All this moisture contains 0 to 16%. Then mineral concentrates are different from cargoes. See iron concentrates. Then characteristic, angle of repose is not given. Then bulk, stowage sizes, class group C, stowage segregation. So hazards is no special hazard. This cargo is non-combustible or has a low fire risk. Then iron ore cargoes may affect the magnetic compass. This one, hold cleaning, no special requirement. Weather precaution, no special requirement. Trimming is accordant with the relevant provision under section 4 and 5. So under this section 4 and 5 of this code. So as the density of the cargo is extremely high, the tank top may be overstressed. Unless the cargo is evenly spread across the tank top, equalize the weight. Due consideration shall be paid to ensure that the tank top is not overstressed during the voyage and during the loading by a pile of the cargo. So these all then loading rates of this cargo are very high. Due consideration shall be paid on the ballasting operations. So ventilation is nothing, carriage no, cleanup no, iron ore pallets also they are asking. So they are also the same. These also you can read, iron ore pallets also. This is page number 187. Then which other cargo is there? Mineral concentrates. Metal sulfur. Okay, so these are few of the mineral concentrates. See, like cement, copper concentrates, iron concentrates. So what is concentrates? The definition is given in these. So these are few of them which is coming in concentrates. So this is actually for all these cargoes description. Then mineral concentrates are the refined ores in which the valuable component have been enriched by the eliminating the bulk or the waste material. So waste material here is removed and only the pure thing is there. So what to do, bulk density, what is around, stowage factors, then hazards and weather precautions, what to do, loadings, all these are given over here. Okay. It cannot be that group of the cargoes cannot be taken. They have taken the group of the cargoes also, like this over here. Then pallets or concentrates, when they ask concentrates, this is the thing we have. The concentrate ores has been palletized. Then moisture up to 6%, bulk density, hazards is no special hazard. This cargo is not combustible, as in low fire stowage, then hold cleaning. They require trimming. Okay, this is pellet rock and something else. Okay, now phosphate. So description, granules similar to the fine sands, ship dry gray, no moisture content and all this. So because this phosphate is sometimes important, so appropriate precaution shall be taken in protected mechanic